Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create this amazing painterly style image using nothing more than Photoshop and its standard filters. Now, there's a few things to check here before you get too into this. Here's the original picture, and we need to make sure that this is an 8-bit image. So I'm going to go to Image, then Mode, and check that it's on 8 bits, which it isn't at the moment, it's 16. So I'm going to click the 8 bits per channel. That means the filters in Photoshop that we need to use are available to us. Now next is the image size. Image and then image size. This came from a 10 million pixel camera, so we're looking for an image size around about that, about 3000 to 4000 pixels. Otherwise the settings I'm going to show you in the filters will have a slightly different effect. Now last thing is the subject itself. For this to work you want a nice graphic subject like this train. Okay, let's get going. We need three copies of this layer. So layer, then duplicate layer and click OK. So we have two layers, and then one more layer, and then duplicate layer and click OK. There you go, three layers. Now actually for the moment we only need one. So I'm going to turn off the visibility of the top two layers by clicking the little eye icons, and then click the bottom layer, the background layer, to make it the active layer. Right, time for some filter fun. So filters, what are we going to use? Well, we have plenty to choose from here, but the first one we're going to use is filter, sketch, and bas relief. Now, bas relief, let's talk about settings in here. I'm going to take the detail up to 12 and the smoothness down to 3, there we go. And I'm going to change the light direction to left and click OK. Now I should say, as I'm using these filters, you can stick to this basic formula, but then go in and try different settings and see how it changes the result. Right, okay, so let's go to my layers again, and we'll turn on the middle layer, we'll click the little eye icon, make it visible, click on the middle layer to make it active, and then I'm going to change the blending mode, because it's currently set to normal, but if I drop the list down, I can change it to colour. And that gives me this nice kind of etched effect, but with a bit of colour, which is kind of nice, but not what I'm after today. Now, we need to collapse those two layers into one. So I'm going to go to Layer and choose Merge Down. And then I can apply a filter to that newly created merged layer. So it's back to filter again. This time we're going to choose the Artistic Cutout. And this is what really makes this picture look the way it does. Because Cutout is a great little filter to use, but how are we going to set it up? Well, let's start with the top. Number of levels I'm going to put to maximum, 8. And then down to the bottom for edge fidelity. And I'm going to take that all the way down to its minimum of 1. Okay, that just leaves us the one in the middle, the edge simplicity. And for that, I'm going to take it to 6 and click OK. And that gives us an interesting effect. That's starting to look like the final image. But we've got one more layer to go and one more filter to apply. So back to the layers, click the top layer to make it visible, and then click the actual layer itself to make it active, and then on for another filter. Filter, Artistic, Cutout. Yes, it's exactly the same filter as I used a moment ago. Precisely the same one, but with a twist. And the twist is kind of minor, but it makes the world of difference. All we're going to do is change the edge simplicity. So before it was on 6, now we're going to increase it to 7. Yep, one number, that's all. And it just changes how this pattern, how this filter effect looks. So when I combine this with the layer below by changing the blending mode, which is normal at the moment, but I'm going to change it to overlay, it just gives you that sort of wow, it just works effect. And it looks superb. You can see how if I go in nice and close, it gives this amazingly artistic looking image, but using Photoshop standard filters. Okay, now I think we can do a little bit of final tidying up here. So let me just flatten that image down, layer and flatten image. And I'm going to use a bit of image adjustments and shadows and highlights to recover some detail from the shadows, perhaps not quite that much, and recover some detail from the highlights, something like that, and click OK. And that just helps to add to that painterly effect. Now, you can use this filter recipe on any picture you like. Try it and see how it works. But I found that it works best on pictures that have a really strong graphic subject. So things like this beach hut, for example. Or things that have foliage with trees and leaves and plants. It gives a sort of wonderful Monet feel. okay, maybe not Monet, but it's in that kind of style. And then anything with a sky, it gives an amazing effect on skies as well. The key is to experiment and to have fun with your photography. Now, if you want to find out more about me, visit my website at www.gavtrain.com. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.